We've had this discussion on our PHNX Sun show before about Kyrie Irving. If there was a scenario where the Suns were able to possibly make a trade for Kyrie Irving, would that or would that not interest you?
Yeah, well, the guy's an unbelievable basketball player. When I say unbelievable, he is, as I call players that's just crazy, I just call him sick. He's sick on the basketball court. He truly is. And, like, I always will tell people, the word perfect is a lie. It's in the dictionary, but nobody's under that heading. No one's perfect. We're all going to make mistakes. We're all going to grow. We're all going to say things. And if you try to make amends for it, you try to move forward, you try to be better, then I respect that individual. Kyrie's a young man that's trying to find himself, and he said some things in the past, and he's taking some stances, some that I didn't agree with. I didn't agree with actually, you know, not being there for his team in regards to getting vaccinated. I don't care where you stand on it. If you don't want to, you don't have to. But when it comes to a team, I think you should. That's been my only issue with him. But as a basketball player, as a young man that's smart, very intelligent, any team would give him a shot. I think he would fit on any team in a high level.
Yeah, you know, listen, there's a lot of complexities with Kyrie Irving, as we know. And I think the one thing about Kyrie that is it. You don't know what your return on investment is going to be on him as an individual, because it's not only just on the court, but what are you going to get, you know, in terms of the extras, right? You know, he hasn't been on the court due to his own control. Mm-hmm. Whether or not you agree with it is another discussion, but it is under his control whether or not he could play. He had one hell of an offseason that almost led to KD wanting to completely get out. And luckily for him, he was, you know, cooler heads prevailed and KD ended up staying. And then at the beginning of the season with the tweet and you know, and all that chaos, like, and then he got suspended from the NBA for that. Like, there's just so many things that are complex that I don't know if I, as an individual, as great as I think Kyrie Irving, from a skill standpoint, is if not the best point guard of all time, I think he's definitely one of the top three or four because of his skills alone. Mm-hmm. Now, when you combat that with the stuff off the court, that's what makes Kyrie, it's just too much of a risk. And if you're the Suns right now and you're in that championship window and you already got a point guard right now, and I'm not trying to disparage Chris Paul because they're in two completely different categories in terms of their conduct and their performance on the court. But Chris Paul has been injured. He has been injury prone in the playoffs. And I feel like you're taking almost the same kind of risk outside of your control, because injuries are outside of your control, with Kyrie Irving off the court. And so I would not like Kyrie Irving on the Suns, even though if you would ask me maybe a year ago, I would have loved him.
Yeah.
So,
well, I think all of us in life are looking for leaders. Everybody can't be a leader. You know, followers have done extremely well in this life. Just go talk to Steve Ballmer, who's the owner of the Clippers. You know, he left school with Bill Gates, and guess what? He's one of the richest men in the world. Paul Allen up in Portland, he passed away, one of the richest men in the world. So it's okay to be a follower. And I think Kyrie was in a battle of, okay, am I okay to be a follower, or do I want to be a leader? And all of that started to happen when he left LeBron, because LeBron was a leader for him. LeBron got him a title. LeBron kept his foot down on him. And I can relate to wanting to break away a little bit, because, and Suns fans will notice, like, Cotton Fitzsimmons was like a father figure of mine. Cotton had me as a pup, like, when I first got in the league. And the way Cotton motivated me was to really ride me hard, man. Like, just constantly, man. Just on top of me, man. And it got to a point in 1990 that I started to fatigue from it. And I wanted to go off and prove that, you know, I didn't need to be under his thumb. And it was a big mistake for me to request a trade, because I did. And Jerry traded me to Seattle. A lot of people don't know that. And I went to Seattle and I learned leadership and I led those guys, and we obviously faced the Suns in 93 in the Western Conference Finals. But I hated that I had to go through that with Kyrie. Kyrie wanted to get away from LeBron. And ever since then, what's happened, right? Mm-hmm. And Boston didn't work out. Brooklyn has been a rocky road, but the story is not finished. And so I just think it's a learning process for everybody. And I think you put a guy like that around great leadership, then I think he'll be fine. And I don't think he had that from a respect category, right? So when I look at the Suns with the hierarchy, the front office and the Suns in general and the players on this team, I don't care how you're viewed or what your past is, you're going to blend in. Because if you got 10 guys, Saul, on one side of positivity, two guys over there by themselves, it's not going to last.
Yeah.
They're going to give in. And that's what it's all about, man. It's about being around guys that you respect and can lead you. And the Suns have a ton of leaders on this team.